even have like lightsabers behind us. They went away. I promise you, they were there. You have to trust me. They were there just a minute ago. Hey, welcome to this game. Well, the theme is not, you know, it's in the Star Wars universe, but it's more specifically Boba Fett. Mm. That old bounty hunter, the mercenary. I hope you are psyched about this game. Are you psyched about this game, Christina?
Super psyched.
You look like you come directly from, something like Star Wars.
Maybe I do.
Well, from the future, at least.
Yeah, that's true.
I am also from the future.
Straight from the future.
So the prize pot for this game, it's 1,500 Mimir tokens. Mm. And this is an elimination game. So make sure that you answer all of the questions correctly, or you will be eliminated.
Yep,
eliminated.
You will be out.
Or Boba Fett will take you out. So do you want to send us right into the first question?
Yes, I would love to. So
let's
are you guys
go.
Ready? Question number one. The jetpack-wearing mercenary Boba Fett is part of what movie universe? The Batman universe, the Star Trek universe, the Star Wars universe, or the X-Men universe?
Oh, now this is the hardest question we've ever had in any game, ever. It is.
It shouldn't be too hard. I think almost everyone's gonna get this one.
Yeah. Okay. Do you feel like saying the answer, Christina?
Of course. And I think everyone's ready because I think most of you have gotten this one right. And it is the Star Wars universe.
Ah,
of course.
I love the Star Wars universe.
Mm.
I wish
big
I had...
Big fan, huh?
I'm a big fan. I wish I had a lightsaber.
I have a feeling you have like a lightsaber toy or something at home.
I used to have. There's a video of me on Facebook when I'm hungover and I have a lightsaber and, you know, it's weird.
So I can find this one online?
Maybe. You know, if it goes up on Facebook, it never goes away. It's something like that, so...
I like it. Okay. I'm gonna search for it.
Yeah. So, question number two. True or false? Boba Fett fell down a Sarlacc pit in Return of the Jedi. True or false? Hmm. Now, what is a Sarlacc pit?
Is it down the pit where, like, the big mouth and everything? What?
Yeah, it's the big, scary...
like a monster.
Toothy.
Right?
Yeah. Mouth thing.
Is it like an underground, like, snake-ish thing? What is it?
Well, I'm not sure that anybody knows what the, like, lower part of the Sarlacc looks like. And I would guess that Star Wars got inspiration about what a Sarlacc should look like from Dune.
That's what I was thinking, too.
Yeah. Now, the correct answer here is true.
It's true.
Boba Fett did fall down that pit.
Yeah, so question number three is, who pushed Boba Fett down the Sarlacc pit? Was it Luke Skywalker, Chewbacca, Han Solo, or Princess Leia?
Douche move, I gotta say. It's a
super
really...
Super douche move.
Yeah, you know, I mean, come on,
no,
down
bro.
The Sarlacc pit. Not down the Sarlacc pit. I mean, you can push me down anywhere.
Push me down the stairs.
Yeah, exactly. Go ahead, you know, I can take the bruises, but I can't take falling down a Sarlacc pit. That's just...
No, bro.
No bueno, bro.
No bueno.
So what's the correct answer here?
Han Douchebag Solo. Yeah.
Well, you know, it serves him right what happened in the first movie of the... you know, the new trilogy. I don't know. Does that trilogy... Maybe it's called that. Trilogy.
Everyone
what's going
knows
on?
Exactly
words,
what
people.
You're talking about.
I'm not
what?
Crazy. I'm not crazy.
Over to question number four, huh?
Yeah, I can pull it off. I can do it.
Thanks.
So, question number four. Who was paying Boba Fett to hunt down Han Solo? Jabba the Hutt, Darth Vader, the Emperor, or Darth Maul?
Hmm.
Well, all of these characters are mean. And, you know, it could be any one of them. But, you know, which one did handed over the money, so to say? Maybe all of them had a hand in it, but one of them had to be handing over the money.
Do you want to tell them who it was?
Yeah, I can do that.
Yeah?
I can.
Yeah.
Yeah, the correct answer is Jabba the Hutt. have you seen Spaceballs?
No.
it's like a Star Wars parody.
Oh, okay.
Where Jabba the Hutt is like, he's a big... Pizza the Hutt is called.
It could be any kind of movie.
Yeah, it could be any kind of movie. Well, this one was, he's a big cheese thing.
Okay.
And it looks really tasty because I like cheese.
Okay. This is very interesting, Jeff.
Thank you.
You like cheese. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
You should definitely go to Italy sometime.
Yeah.
I can't believe you've never been there, being Italian. Okay.
Yeah.
Over to question number 5. What actor plays Boba Fett in the new TV series, The Book of Boba Fett? Is it Giancarlo Esposito, Pedro Pascal, Bruce Willis, or Temuera Morrison? Sorry. Yeah.
Well, you know, seeing that he rarely takes off his helmet.
Temuera? Yeah, yeah. He rarely takes off his helmet. How are we supposed to know?
Yeah, yeah.
But we have gotten a few glimpses, so...
It could be anyone. In fact, actually, in most of the scenes, I am actually playing Boba Fett.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's true. But when they take off the helmet, it is the actor...
So when the helmet is on, it's really you?
Yeah, it's true, actually. But when they take it off, it's Temuera Morrison.
Oh, cool. And also cool, you know how to pronounce his name.
Oh, thank you.
Love it. Okay, question number 6. Would you like to take it away?
Yeah. Of course. In the original Star Wars movies, Boba Fett spoke all these quotes, except he's no good to me dead, he's worth a lot to me, as you wish, or always a pleasure to meet a Jedi.
So, the one he did not say, that's the question. Okay.
Yeah.
Which one can it be? Tricky.
Yeah, if I like act them out as Boba Fett would do, since I...
Yeah?
I obviously know how to act as Boba Fett. It's
obviously, if you're the actor.
Yeah, so maybe this will help you. He's no good to me dead.
That's not helping, Jeff.
He's worth a lot to me.
Okay.
As you wish.
Oh.
Always a pleasure to meet a Jedi. So, well, the correct answer here is always a pleasure to meet a Jedi.
Loving the accent.
Yeah, I guess you could probably hear it. Something sounded off with that one in particular.
The last one was very Italian, I have to tell you. Okay.
Yeah.
Question number 7. Which of these facts are true? Jango Fett is Boba Fett's father. Boba Fett is a clone of Jango Fett. Jango Fett is Boba Fett's cousin. They are not related at all. Which of these facts are true?
I think of... you remember, what was it, yesterday when we did... Or the day before when we did the Illuminati things?
Trust me, I remember.
Yeah.
Love that show. Okay,
yeah.
Had so much fun.
And we were talking about clones.
Yeah.
And I'm starting to feel like, is this a conspiracy here that we talk about clones here as well? Well, the correct answer here is Boba Fett is a clone of Jango Fett.
Yes.
So the, kind of the government went in there, made a clone, and, you know, it's all the conspiracy stuff. It's all real.
It's all true and it's all real. Okay. Would you like to take question number 8, Jeff?
I would love to. True or false, Boba watched Mace Windu murder his clone father, Jango Fett. True or false? You know, I feel like there's more than one douches in this story.
There are a few.
I mean, Mace Windu, come on, it's Samuel Jackson, but I mean, he's... that's not a nice move.
No. Nope.
Killing someone's clone father? I mean, killing someone's father, that's okay, but clone father? Clone father?
Crossing
are
the
you
line,
kidding
bro?
Me?
Crossing the line.
Well, what's the correct answer here, Christina?
It's true.
It is true. Yeah. So, Mace Windu, come on. Do you want to take us to the next question, Christina?
I would love to. Question number 9. In the new series, The Mandalorian, we see the protagonist use the same kind of armor as used by Boba Fett. What is this kind of armor made of? Is it Nexus Iron, Beskar Steel, Legenda Steel, or Magma Steel?
Yeah, one thing is for sure that I would love to have that type of armor. I mean, because I usually...
To your
I wear
collection of...
Of all of my armors.
Yes. And weapons.
As you do, you know,
yeah.
People... it's not weird having an armor. I would like to point that out because I feel like you're making it sound like it's weird to have an armor. And
I mean, I've
it
seen
really
so
isn't.
Many weapons. Like
you should see how many
everything.
People have armors. It's you wouldn't believe. You would not believe.
Okay. Would you like to tell them the correct answer?
Yeah, the correct
then?
Answer is Beskar steel. So that's usually when I'm on the set and playing Boba Fett. You know, I'm wearing that steel.
Awesome. Okay.
Yeah, so the last question here, people. Question number 10. Which of the following items is Boba Fett known to wear on his armor as a trophy? Wookiee scalps, Sarlacc teeth, Rancor claws, or Reek horns?
Dope.
Yeah. I mean, all of these are, you know, it's proof of being a formidable warrior.
So I'm guessing you have something like this at home too, right?
Yes, yeah. But I was just going to ask you if you have any trophies that you wear on your armor.
You would be surprised.
I would.
Maybe I should wear them sometimes on the show.
Yeah, that would.
Yeah.
It's like a banana or something.
Maybe. We'll see. Like a pineapple thing or
so
something.
So what's the correct answer here, Christina?
Wookiee scalps.
There we go. Huh. Mm. So we made it through this Boba Fett themed quiz.
Yeah, this was awesome.
This was awesome. I like being from the future. I'm really happy for those of you who made it through all of this. How do you feel about life?
I'm feeling great about life. And you know what else I'm feeling super pumped about? Our next show.
Oh, I am feeling pumped about that as well.
Yeah.
So until then, people, I wish you a continued lovely evening.
See you soon. Bye, everyone.